Today's quick tip is a real simple and essential one for fountain pen enthusiasts and people getting started with fountain pens is how to fill a fountain pen converter. So today we have the Laban Forest, and it is a cartridge converter pen, has the converter already installed, and we're going to give this a go with Robert Oster Evergreen. Forest and Evergreen, figure it goes together well. So you have the converter here is already attached. You want to make sure that the converter is firmly attached to the section. Then you're going to screw down the piston by turning the knob here counterclockwise, and it's going to go all the way down to the front until it goes down no more. And then you're going to take your bottle of ink, have it open here, have a little bit of towel just to make sure that if any messes occur that they're quickly dealt with. And we're going to put the nib up to the section of the pen here, and then we're going to screw up the converter, and it is just drawing air. So what we're going to do is sometimes it just kind of takes going up and down a couple of times just to get the, there we go. So it's a pretty good fill right there. If you do want to get rid of that air bubble, then you would just take the nib and point it skyward, get the ink down towards the back of the converter, and then you would gently just screw the piston clockwise to release some of the air bubbles that are stuck in there. And then you would just dip the nib back in and suck up the rest of the ink that's in there. But if you can go quite a bit with this kind of filling of a converter. It doesn't necessarily have to be completely full for you to take advantage of it for a while and to be able to write for a long time. So this would probably last me, like it would probably last at least like a week or two, this amount of ink that's in here. So then you would just want to make sure that you wipe down the section, especially an ivory or white or a demonstrator section. Ink tends to show through quite a bit on here. So then you would take the barrel, put that back on, put the cap back on, and most importantly, make sure that the bottle cap of the ink is back on, and you're good to go. Thanks, guys.